on behalf of the United States Coast Guard and the entire Unified Command, I offer my deepest condolences to the families.
The Titan, a deep-sea submersible on a mission to explore the Titanic wreckage, has been found in pieces after a catastrophic implosion, resulting in the tragic death of all five people on board, as reported by the U.S. Coast Guard. During its dive, the submersible lost contact with its surface support ship, leading to its disappearance. A robotic diving vehicle later discovered the debris field of the Titan near the Titanic wreckage, with significant fragments of the submersible located on the seabed. The victims of this unfortunate incident include OceanGate Expedition's founder and CEO, Stockton Rush, British billionaire Hamish Harding, businessman Shahzada Dawood and his son Suleiman, and French oceanographer Paul-Henri Narjolet. Despite the extensive multinational search effort involving the US, Canada, France, and Britain, hopes of finding survivors were shattered upon the discovery of the Titan wreckage. The debris field indicated a catastrophic implosion, suggesting that the submersible met its fate.
Essentially, we found five different major pieces of debris that told us that it was the remains of the Titan.
The exact cause and timing of the incident remain unclear, but the proximity of the debris field to the Titanic wreckage and the absence of loud noises during the search suggest that the failure likely occurred toward the end of the submersible's descent. This tragic event highlights the dangers and challenges associated with deep-sea exploration. Concerns regarding the safety of the missing submersible Titan have emerged, with experts and a whistleblowing employee raising alarms in 2018 about the safety practices of OceanGate expeditions. The 22-foot-long submersible was not certified by recognized third-party organizations such as the American Bureau of Shipping, or DNV, which established design safety standards for underwater vehicles. Worries were expressed about OceanGate's experimental approach and the potential negative consequences it could have on the industry. In a letter addressed to OceanGate's CEO, Stockton Rush, concerns were highlighted regarding the design, fabrication, and testing process of the submersible, raising alarms about potential serious outcomes. These safety concerns were brought up during an annual symposium, prompting the chairman of the Marine Technology Society's Committee on Manned Submersibles to send the letter to Rush on behalf of the society.
A lot of them got together and wrote a letter to OceanGate and said, you have to certify. You cannot take people down. It's irresponsible, and it could lead to catastrophe.
Additionally, a former employee named David Lockridge had forwarded an engineering report that criticized OceanGate's research and development process, citing concerns about the materials used in the hull and the lack of testing performed. Lockridge was subsequently terminated, and legal disputes ensued between Lockridge and OceanGate, involving allegations of sharing confidential information. Operated by OceanGate Expeditions, the van-sized Titan descended on Sunday, but lost contact with its support ship, putting the five individuals on board at risk of running out of oxygen. With a critical shortage of air supply, the submersible had approximately 96 hours of oxygen, potentially depleting by Thursday morning, although various factors could affect the precise time of oxygen depletion, such as power availability and onboard conditions. To locate the Titan, a robot from a French research ship has been deployed to the seabed. However, even if the submersible is found in time, the rescue operation faces significant challenges due to the extreme depth of over 2 miles. Despite undersea noises recorded by Canadian search planes, subsequent searches using remote-controlled underwater vehicles have yielded no results, leaving officials uncertain about the source of the sounds.
So the ocean is a very complex place. Obviously, human sounds, nature sounds, and it's very difficult to discern what the source of those noises are at times.
The Titanic sank in 1912 after colliding with an iceberg, resulting in over 1,500 casualties. Resting approximately 900 miles east of Cape Cod, Massachusetts, and 400 miles south of St. John S., Newfoundland, the exploration of the Titanic's wreckage represented a high-priced tourist adventure offered by OceanGate, costing $250,000 per person. Notable figures on board the Titan included British billionaire Hamish Harding, Pakistani-born business magnate Shahzada Dawood, his son Suleiman, French oceanographer Paul-Henri Nargileh, and Stockton Rush, the CEO of OceanGate and a descendant of Titanic victims. Rescue efforts face formidable obstacles at the extreme depths of the ocean floor, with experts expressing skepticism about the feasibility of a sub-to-sub rescue and the challenge of locating the missing Titan submersible within the vast Titanic debris field. The inhospitable terrain, characterized by extreme pressure, darkness, freezing temperatures, and muddy seabed, presents significant difficulties for the rescue operations. With the search area covering a vast expanse and limited resources available, recovering the submersible becomes an immensely challenging task. We make videos on current issues. Support us through your likes, share, and subscribe our channel as well.
And we knew that if the sub passed its pressure test, it wasn't going to fail on the first dive. It might fail on dive 7, or I don't know what they're at, you know, but it's going to fail over time.
The missing OceanGate expedition, which aimed to explore the deep sea wreck of the Titanic, reflects the rise of extreme tourism, offering thrilling and high-priced adventures to individuals seeking unique experiences. Similar to the competition in the space tourism industry among billionaire entrepreneurs, OceanGate's venture aimed to push the boundaries of exploration in the depths of the ocean. However, this incident highlights the need for careful consideration of safety measures in extreme tourism. As extreme tourism gains traction, companies and regulators must prioritize safety, transparency, and the well-being of participants in deep sea and space expeditions. The concerns raised by experts in 2018 regarding the safety of OceanGate's submersible emphasize the importance of adhering to rigorous certification processes and industry standards to mitigate potential risks. Balancing the allure of extraordinary experiences with robust safety measures will ensure the sustainability of these ventures and the protection of participants. The allure of discovering historical treasures and witnessing awe-inspiring sights captivates adventurers who are willing to pay a premium for such experiences, but it is vital to prioritize the well-being and safety of participants. Thanks for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel for more interesting videos.